We are at Energetab 2023 at Schneider Electric stand with Mr. Grzegorz. Nice to meet you, sir.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Could you tell our viewers, for those who don't know, a little bit about Schneider Electric?
Yeah, so generally Schneider Electric is a global leader in digitization of the energy management and also on the energy efficiency, but also in industrial automation.
Okay, and here we can see one of your products that you brought to Energetab. Maybe we can talk about it.
Yeah, so here we have a small enclosures, Prisma Set G. Within each we have a switchgear related to the final distribution, but as well as switching between the main supply and the backup supply. What we want to show here, it is a Actinine Active, which is an all-in-one protection, which means that in one device, which is 36 millimeters width, we have protection, over voltage protection, over current protection, residual current protection, as well as arc fault detection. On top of that, we have monitoring. We can measure power, energy, voltage, and other parameters, and send it remotely to the communication gateway. This is panel server. With the communication via Modbus TCP, we can visualize the data on the web server, or thanks to this gateway, we can, I would say, use it also for other external BMS systems. On this web server, we can see some basic parameters that we have access to thanks to Actinine Active. We can see here current, voltage, power, and energy consumption, and it is for each circuit where such device is used. Thanks to this, the visibility of the whole installation is much more, I would say, convincible for the customers, and we can see much more than if you use only, I would say, standard devices like this. This is the sensor for the monitoring of the air quality within the enclosures. Thanks to that, we can observe what is the temperature of the inside the cabinet, what is the humidity, but also what is the air quality. For example, if we have a question of problem with overheating of the conductors, some chemicals will be visible in the air, and it can be informed to us by this sensor, and we can prevent and make some maintenance so that our enclosure will still be operating very good for the next time.
And this little tool,
this
is it for?
This is something to, I would say, to show what is the air condition within the enclosure. With this, we can simulate the chemicals that will then engage within the enclosure, and we can see that the state of this sensor will change, yes? With the worse conditions of air quality, then it will be observed by the sensor, and then we send to the communication gateway.
And I hope, is it going to be visible right now?
Yeah, we should see it. Like the color of this indicator should be changed from green to red.
Oh
yeah. So here we can see it. Then after that, we should see it also on this website. Mm-hmm. This is our last launched product for switching between the basic supply of the power and the backup supply. It is a compact design of the all-in-one solution for the cases where we need backup supply for our small commercial building, I would say mainly.
Okay, and this works fast automatically.
Yeah, we can make some adjustments so that it fits better to our initial solution that we would like to.
There is also Ethernet connector, so you can modify
but,
it.
Yeah, this is generally to this panel server. Thanks to this, we can communicate directly to computer, but also we can connect it to any BMS that can be used with Modbus TCP. But generally, it's an open communication, so it is not a problem to use it for the other systems.
I have a final question, just an overall. Because in Energetab we have a large field dedicated for renewable energy. How do you think Schneider Electric is connected and perhaps think about it?
Yeah, thanks to this solution we can monitor what is the amount of energy produced, for example, by the photovoltaic system, what is the energy consumed by the user, what is the energy exported to the utilities. So that is why, thanks to this analysis, we can observe whether our system is optimal, or we should change something so that he can make a better, I would say, results for us.
I also can see that your booth over here is pretty green and connected to renewables and sustainable. Can you tell a little bit about how Schneider sees it?
Yeah, generally sustainability is the core of our functioning. Here at Schneider, we focus on that so that we make the most of the energy that is used. For example, with these devices, we can monitor energy, make our solutions more efficient. But also from the production side, when we produce our devices, we use packaging that comes from recycled materials. Also, when it is possible, the raw materials used for the production are also with the recycled materials.
All right.
So this is a very important topic for Schneider.
Yes, of course. For the future.
Yeah, that's right. That's okay. Right. For the future, I'll plan.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
After a small break, I'm right here at Schneider Electric stand with Bartek. And Bartek will present us this magic box, the Thesis Island. Could you tell us what is it?
Oh, this is the whole new level of the Industry 4.0 if we are talking about the motor management. Because we at Schneider Electric, we are thinking about how to add the new features, how to add the connectivity, the data acquiring, and the motor management on the whole new level into the single contactor. So we came with our completely new product, which is Thesis Island. Islands of the contactors that can be operated via PLC controller. We have the island of contactors connected together. We manage it via the PLC controller or via the computer, where we have the dedicated application to manage the motors. So what can we do basically beside controlling just the electrical motor? We acquire data, so we know how long it works. We know everything about the current, voltage, so the energy consumption. And the second thing, that we can manage these motors. So here we can see the counters, how does the motor operate, the history of the of this motor, and also the trip status. So let's say for less technical people, like health of the motor, okay? And now if, let's say something happens, the motor breaks or it's jumped, it's blocked here.
So you're applying
load. As you can see, it's stopped operating, but the current is still going. And now, because we set up the alarm threshold and the reset threshold, this smart contactor knows that something is wrong with our motor. Maybe it's broken or maybe it's blocked, and it can stop the motor. Now it started to work, so it automatically blocked the motor. Now we can see it here. We have an alarm as in this management tool. We can also have this information inside our PLC controller. And what is more, the contactor calculates why this failure happened. So on the basis of the current, of the voltage, and all the data, it can calculate why it stopped or why it didn't start, for example.
In this case?
In this case, it says that it's jammed. So something maybe is broken here or something get into this mechanical part. So the motor stopped. And this is not the situation that the controller wanted to do. So it says us that something is wrong. There we have an alarm here,
right,
and also alarm in PLC. The PLC can send this information to the control room or to the automation engineer. So we know that something happened and we know what happened. So we reduce the downtime. We reduce the time to fix this issue. So our machine can operate for a longer time.
Right.
And so time is money, of course.
Right. We would like to reduce it as much as possible. Zero downtime.
Yes, that would be great. Of course, this is not possible in the real life, but time is money, so we want to reduce it as much as possible.
And it also can predict when it's going to be the next time for maintenance, for example.
We plan to add some new features because this is still a new product. So we planned some evolutions for it. And one of these evolutions will be the predictive maintenance. So the additional module that calculates how do we use this motor, and it can give us some providing data about when should we make some service process or when should we exchange this motor to avoid the failure. So this would be even better because we don't wait for the failure. We know when it will more or less happen, and we can provide.
Right, and I see that this is this box is very. You can carry it around with you.
Yes.
So you can go to the place where to the infrastructure and test it on the place. You can connect it, and I see that you can have here many modules. So it's a modular.
Yes, yes, it is modular. We can install here up to 20 modules. It will be more or less 1 meter of this installation. So up to 20 motors.
Okay.
But of course, we can use many islands. Another good point, according to this test island, is that we do not have to have any specialized knowledge about how to program it. It's more configuration than programming. So we can, in our tool, we can use predefined function blocks. We call it avatars. So we have avatars for motors, for heaters, and so on, and just configure these avatars about the power, about the trip threshold, about the reset threshold, and all the information that we want to acquire from the island. This is pure configuration, and on the end, in this software, it gives us bill of material, so we know exactly what to order and how to connect it.
That's wonderful.
Connectivity also is a very good thing here, because everything here is connected via one port, and then we connect this island via standard Ethernet connection or Profinet or Profibus connection to the PLC controller. We don't have to make the connection of the signal connection of each controller. We do only the one Ethernet connection here, and then everything is connected inside.
All right, so there is connect by bus.
Yes.
And so this PLC is from Schneider?
Yes, this is also PLC from Schneider Electric. Of course, we are fully compatible with all Schneider Electric PLCs, but also we are prepared to be connected with the third-party devices. So we are not afraid, let's say, of any modernization of any projects when we are mixed with other companies. We can cooperate with the most important companies on the world, and we can connect this product to the systems that already exist, or maybe they are planned for from some.
Wait a second. Is this motor still running?
No, because it's not. I can unplug it. No, that's how it works. It stopped working.
It stopped the motor.
It stopped the motor. Yes.
Right. Okay.
The connector switched off because it sees that something happened.
Okay.
It delivers data to the main module. The main module makes calculation, and the main module sends the information to the PLC. Okay, motor number one is stopped, and this is because it was jammed.
Right. And when you have the bill of materials from this device, go to TME and order it. Thank you, Bartek.
Thank you.